Today I'm going to show you some stretches for your upper body, just so that we can reverse the effects of perhaps sitting with rounded shoulders for a little bit too much during our days. So if you're at home, find yourself a wall that's nice and blank that you can use as a prop. So we're going to start with a stretch across your chest for our muscle of the pec. And it almost looks like a little bit of a fan going out with the center starting at the midline and then opening towards the shoulder. There are a lot of nerves that are underneath this area of the body as well, so you might feel a slight nerve stretch, which is not too bad as long as you don't feel like you're getting a headache from it. So start standing side on and place your hand in line with your shoulder. Things to watch for is that you're not going to bring your shoulder forward out of the socket or take it back and pinch the shoulder. So you're just going to keep that line nice and open at the front of the body. And then with small little steps, we walk away from the arm and you should start to feel that nervous stretch coming down under your arm all the way into the palm. Stay there for a few breaths just until you feel like the tension begins to ease and then walk back to the start. Moving up a level, so thinking of the fingertips now perhaps at the top level of your ear, and the same movement again, just a gentle tip tap of your feet away from the wall. Breathe into that opening, thinking of that fanning of the muscle widening, and then coming back. And then the third one to finish with is bringing the fingertips almost like they were in line with the top of your head, or maybe a little higher, but always feeling like your arm is settled down against your body, not being raised up toward your ear, and moving away, same little move from the side. So here, particularly as the arm gets higher, watch that that shoulder doesn't come forward. And then returning back to the beginning. Before you do the other side, just have a moment to feel the difference between the two sides of the body. Maybe you'll even feel that one arm is slightly longer than the other. All right, you're ready for the next side. So now that you've had that chance to open up both sides of your chest, we're ready to take it into a stretch for the arms, starting from the upper arm and then really lengthening down almost towards your pelvis. So this time we'll turn to face toward the wall and bring your hands out in line with the shoulders again. Take a look at your feet and make sure that they're sitting right underneath your sit bone position. So you're in a good right angle position. We're going to keep the elbows straight here and start to walk up the wall as you start to lengthen through the underarm. So you don't want to go so high that you begin to bring the shoulders up because it feels uneasy. So still feeling like the arms are dropping back and down into the body. And then stop where you feel comfortable. Everyone will feel slightly different. And then just taking a few breaths in, like you're trying to breathe open the space underneath your arms. And then walking back, pushing off one arm or one hand so that you feel a long line again until you get back to your shoulders. And you can do that a few times, and each time you go up, maybe you get a little bit higher through the movement. Some things to watch for again, we've spoken about the shoulders creeping up, but also watch that you don't dip into the body. So you still want to keep a long line through the front and the back of your waists. And then walking back again. So once we've done stretching, it's always a nice way to finish it up with a little bit of strengthening. So this would be a good push-up preparation. So have the hands facing on the wall, your elbow creases looking up towards the ceiling, and then just begin to bend the elbows until they touch the wall, hopefully, and then push back up. So when you start to do that movement, you'll feel that the back of the shoulder blades are not pinching in towards each other, but they're staying really set on the width of your rib cage. So again, doing maybe 5, 10, 15, depends how excited you get. And then we'll be finished with all of that. So I hope those stretches were helpful again, just for your everyday sort of working out the stresses of the life behind the desk. And I look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye.